All right, man, we got another episode. Illegal.
We're back.
How you feeling?
It's a good day to be alive.
It is a good day.
It's a good day to be alive.
Kenyon, how you feeling?
Hey, we in the building, man. You know the vibes.
All right. Guess what I just did?
Oh, I know what you just did.
Guess what I just did?
I don't know, thanks.
I went on a date.
A date?
I went on a date. Could be considered a blind date, but I saw her first, so it's not.
Did she ask you your credit score?
Hold on.
She did not.
You know, that's one of my questions that I asked.
You want to know who it is? Codename the Night's Watch.
Whoa!
The what? Say that again? One more?
Codename the Night's Watch.
The Night's Watch?
Because I just slayed a...
Oh!
That's a little bit racist. Just a tad bit. Just a tad bit.
The cold ones? What are it's you just, talking about?
It's just a tad bit racist. But anyway... You know,
how was it?
So pretty much, if you can just close your eyes, imagine how you think it went. That's exactly how it went. I'm gonna bounce back. I'm gonna be all right. I'll be
but
all
right. You ain't had nothing to talk about.
I always got something to say, man.
I closed my eyes and you said close your eyes and imagine.
Okay, you got it. You got it. You got it.
Eyes and I said, boy, didn't talk about nothing.
You got it. Anyway, we got a. We got a special guest. We got a special guest.
Yes.
I know we usually stick to the music thing sometimes, but today we got somebody that's going to teach us some things.
Yes, man.
Yes.
Through education, accomplishments. She's actually done what she's going to talk about.
Ooh.
So yes. She knows what she's talking about.
Yes.
How about you introduce yourself?
Yes. First of all, thank you for having me. Mm-hmm. My name is Kaylani. I'm here to talk about my home buying experience.
Awesome.
Yes.
Okay.
I know y'all usually talk about music, and we can talk about music because music got me through this experience.
Okay. Like,
do your thing.
It was a long haul.
Okay.
But yeah, so I'm 21 and I bought a home. I bought a home on my own.
Exactly.
Yes.
Not least, she owns it.
Own it. Own. Yes. And I'm just here to drop some gems. Yeah, so I guess I'll just start with what the heck happened. So it was 2020 and COVID hit.
The vid.
Yeah, COVID hit. It was March. I just came back from spring break. I was in college at ODU. And
ODU? Where's ODU?
In Virginia.
ODU?
Old Dominion University.
Old Dominion, okay. Look.
No, you never heard of it?
I heard of it now, but...
I heard of King's Dominion.
Yo, King's Dominion, the only Dominion I know. Yeah.
You know what? I'm cracking up.
Look, good. Everybody's heard of Old Dominion.
Hampton, Norfolk State. Y'all heard
Hampton,
of those?
Yeah,
so it's like near Norfolk State.
Okay.
So yeah, I went to college there and came back from spring break and everything was shut down. And, you know, I'm finishing up my classes and everything and I'm like, damn, like, where am I going to live after this? Like, I was about to graduate. I'm like, yo, like, what's happening after this? And I remember I'm online looking at apartments and things. And my boyfriend, Isaiah, he wanted to move to D.C.
Oh, hell no!
D.C. is a good place to move?
Yeah, you get 400 square feet for, like, 2,100.
You get I know people who are living out D.C. Shout out to all my D.C. folks.
Man.
They're getting compensated that money where they living. I'm telling you, they live a good life. You know what I'm talking about.
I'm not vouching for DC. I'm not doing it. I won't.
I wanted to be there, but it was so expensive. I'm like, dang, like, this is crazy. And then so I was just like, dang, I could buy a house with that much, like with that amount of money per month, you know, paying for 400 square feet. And so I just started like watching all these videos about becoming a homeowner and wasn't getting anywhere. Like,
okay,
you know how
trying
you
trying to grab that YouTube University. I mean,
they'd be like, today I'm going to teach you how to become a homeowner. I'm going to show you all the steps and all this and that. And then you get like 20 minutes in and you'd be like, so.
The introduction sound good though, man. The advertising
presentation was great
about.
Too.
Man, they set it up nicely.
Did you buy a course?
Did you? How many?
I bought one.
Okay.
It was $20.
No, that's not bad.
Okay.
That's
some people bad. Like, you know, dive in like
400.
Four, yeah, like 400 try easy. Go to classes and stuff.
That's
like,
that's a thing of gas. That's a thing of gas.
Man, I could have went to Chick-fil-A with my $20.
Look,
what?
We'll talk about Chick-fil-A later, right? Look. Now my feelings are mixed about. I know. Now you got my feelings all mixed up.
Yeah, you're a red. You're a red member.
Because I just got done watching Judas in the Black Messiah. Just
great film. Great film.
Let's just keep talking about houses.
I ain't seen it.
You ain't seen it.
I'm not.
You gotta get there.
I'm busy.
Get there.
I'll be busy.
He says he's
busy going on dates. That could have been a date. That's your next date.
Man. You know what? He should have brought that to go see Judas.
That would have been an experience. And you would have had something to talk about.
You guys are on fire right now. All right, yeah, man, let's go. Y'all clicking on all cylinders. Okay. All right, I like the chemistry, but dial it back a bit.
Look, man, go ahead. Back to the house.
Yeah, all right, the house, yes.
$20.
$20, man. So I bought a course, whatever. I got nothing out of the course. It was all a scam. And I was like, you know what, man? Forget these courses. I'm going to just start calling places. So I'm calling banks. Yeah, I'm calling banks. I'm like, can I speak to your lending department? And they're like, okay, you know, I'm speaking to different lenders. Some were just so mean and rude. I'm telling them my scenario, like, you know, I told them I graduated college, even though I didn't.
Oh, yeah. I was going to ask, but, you know, I let the story rock.
Well, you know, you got to make it sound good.
It did sound great.
I just graduated college and everything. And, you know,
they don't want to hear that. That definitely didn't sound good to them. You know how hard it is getting a job out of college? I was about to be like,
oh, damn, okay.
They don't want to hear that.
Already in debt. Like, you want to borrow more money? You want to borrow more? They're not trying to hear that, no. But continue.
Man, it was able to be done somehow. I mean, I was able to start the process unemployed and without my college degree yet. So it all went well.
Wow. Yeah, well.
Yeah, I was completely unemployed. But I'm gonna get there. So what happened? Oh yeah, I'm calling lenders and things, and they were super unhelpful. They were just like, well, what's your credit score? I tell them my credit score and things, and it was significantly high. It was pretty
above 650?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, well, it was a pretty strong credit score.
That's mid level right there. Only above 650, you're good.
Well,
yeah, I started chipping away at my credit pretty early.
When you start asking about above 650, you don't want to be talking about numbers.
Yeah.
You feel me? You're above 650, that's a nice number. You feel me?
Yeah,
out 21, you feel me? Good.
Yeah. So what happened next? Oh, yeah, I'm calling lenders and things, and, you know, I'm telling them my scenario. I'm a recent graduate of college and this and that. They're like, oh, well, you know, you should really focus on getting your master's degree before worrying about buying a house, or it's not very ideal. Like, I literally had people tell me it's not ideal to purchase a home at my age.
I guess they try to help the renters.
Maybe they're trying to help DC make more money off me or something. And it was really discouraging at first. But then I came across this one lady, her name was Reagan Turnbull with Evolve Bank and Trust, right? And I sent her an email explaining my situation. Hey, I just graduated college, da, da, da. And then she asked me, what's my employment history? I'm like, well, I don't have much. I've been in college. And she's like, oh, that's employment history. I'm like, being a student is employment history? Mm. I got hella employment history.
Right? No.
And so that was like the first big thing that got me through. Like, okay, I got employment history now. Being a student is being employed. And then she asked me, do I have a job? I'm like, no. And she's like, well, can you get one lined up in the next 30 days? I'm like, yeah.
Can you? You was both. Go ahead. Keep it. Go ahead.
Listen, I'm telling you, it's not that hard.
I think you manifested that one. Go ahead.
All you need is an employment contract.
Ooh.
To start the home buying process.
What is an employment contract? For the basics, they don't know.
No,
employment contract. Basically, it's a job offer. So you will start X job on X date making X amount, and this is how many hours you're guaranteed per week.
The job offer. Your job offer. Solidified.
Okay.
The
paper says, so what are you grabbing yours at? Go ahead. Continue the story.
Just to clarify, you have to get the job to get a job offer, right?
The job has to offer you the job.
What are you talking about? I mean, you have to offer it to you.
You got to have a date that you will begin working there.
Right.
Just produce like 4 pay stubs.
Just make it clear for the scammers out there.
I know.
You hear me? I tried to scam. Like, you don't got to keep the job. Just say you got it and leave it. Swipe them cards.
And tell them, and go ahead now.
Call somebody's grandma and tell them, man.
Listen.
This is the IRS.
This is the IRS.
We need 4,000 right now.
Yeah, man.
So go ahead with the story. Yeah. So where did you get your employment contract from?
So I've been
30 days.
I spent all summer applying to jobs. Mm-hmm. Like I'm just applying. I'm applying to like Bank of America and like just any freaking where I'm watching commercials on TV. Like maybe I can work there. Maybe I can work for Progressive. Maybe I can work for here. Because you know I wanted like a white collar job.
Okay.
And you know
you
I got a college degree.
Yeah, you feel me?
Yeah.
You got education.
I ain't getting none of them. Mm. They sent me them emails. We're sorry. You know we found someone more qualified. And I'm like, oh man. But then I found a loophole. Somebody was like, girl, why don't you hit up a staffing agency? I'm like, yo, what is that? And they get you in quick as a mug with good
Shout
jobs.
Shout out to all the staffing agencies.
Listen, if you need a job on a quick tip, go to a staffing agency.
Hey, shout them out. Shout hey, them, you know, I've been at the same job for 10 years.
Man. But you know them staffing agencies, man.
Man, I ain't going to shout the name out because I don't deal with them no more. But
they be looking out. Who's Amazon's staffing agency? Integrity. Shout out to Integrity.
Integrity staffing.
They put me.
Look, you had a bad experience.
Integrity staffing agency. They ever got me a job? Never got me a job.
They paid me every Friday. They made sure
every Friday.
Every Friday on time.
What's that job by Blockbuster?
Awesome.
I'm sorry. Y'all who are too young to know what Blockbuster is, this is a place where you can go every Friday, get a nice movie for $3 before it was released, and
you know
enjoy with your family.
But he said, like, enjoy it's with still there. John went out of business 10
But y'all know
years.
Where it is. You know where the landmark
the
is.
The west side of Dover, if you're not unfamiliar. Whose staffing agency is that?
Doesn't matter. They didn't help me. That's all that matters.
They didn't help
you
me.
You suck.
Man, I went blank, but I know Integrity and. I know what Kraft got some staffing agency they use. Purdue does too. Shout out to Purdue.
Man, look, bottom line, you want to get somewhere quick, but not him though. Just not you. It doesn't work for you. As long as you're not this guy here, you're good to go.
He probably went into the interview just like his date, didn't say nothing at all.
Probably had his hat on like that.
Oh! Your date didn't like you because your hat, son. You didn't have a chain on, man. It's your fault. It's your fault.
That bare neck.
There we go, shot.
She said no money ass.
You gave her some jokes. Yo, you gave her some jokes to come on here with that. You said, yo, flame him up.
I went to the staffing agency, told him I graduated. My degree I did not graduate.
What were you going to school for?
Speech therapy.
Okay.
Yeah. I'm supposed to be a speech therapist, but other ventures in life, other ventures.
That's what you graduated with?
Well, that's what she wanted.
Okay. Well, I did graduate.
Okay.
I graduated December 2020, turned up, woo-woo, Bachelor's of Science.
Okay.
So glad to be done. College was a good time, but man, I don't miss that dang work.
Every time I hear about people graduating college, they cry. I mean, I remember
it was a movie.
I remember Codename
Kids Next Door.
Well, I don't want to say his name because he cried.
We have code names on here. I know he didn't. Like,
we can't. We can't say the name of the person who we need to refer to.
I see.
They would be addressed as code name
with something.
And he cried. He cried at graduation. He cried thanking everybody. He cried like a baby. I was damn, that must have been
the snotty cry.
He was like, hey, I wanted to quit. I wanted to quit so bad.
Right.
But y'all kept me pushing. That was
Man. Somebody must have been recording.
Did y'all go to war in there? Like this.
I'll say my college degree doesn't mean anything in the present workforce, but that college degree really do show some dedication.
Right.
Man, because it was some nights I didn't know if I was going to make it.
Mm.
Whether it was because of the Henny or whether it was because. Or whether it was just because. It was
like
just
you was out for yourself.
Nah, she with
the Henny or some. Or the bullets is going to take me. Like, smooth Philly vibes over
you're
here.
You're the UD.
I was in Virginia.
Old Dominion.
I was in Virginia. Virginia's fun. It was a good time.
So you just. How close?
Forget about the bullets, the nooses.
Oh my gosh, I was like 25 minutes from Hampton and like 7 minutes from Norfolk State.
Oh, you was lit.
So them HBCUs go up.
You was lit.
It was fun. Where was I with my story? Yeah. So I called them. You know, they got me a job quick, fast, and in a hurry. I was I worked for TRICARE. I worked for TRICARE, the military veterans health, and I processed.
Okay. Shout out to
health insurance claims, and that got me through. I worked there for 1 month, 4 weeks, 4 paychecks, 21 days.
Bang.
Counted every single day. Dang. Met them requirements, and I was good to skate.
Wow.
Oh yeah, you was scamming. Yep,
yeah.
I wasn't scamming. What I did was I learned the ropes, and I
Is it scamming when you know the rules?
Yes.
No.
What do you mean?
A scam is a scam.
It's not a scam.
If you know the exact amount of time.
Four weeks. That's public information.
People don't read. That's easy information.
That's like an athlete. That's like a football player saying you got to catch 80 touchdowns.
That's like a football player saying I need to piss on this day and this day and make sure it's clean right now. And I can shoot up the rest of those days.
She didn't shoot any. Was she shot up knowledge or something?
Man, I did shoot up knowledge.
Knowledge, man.
Disclaimer. Just want to put a disclaimer out there.
I gotta have 80 catches, 5 touchdowns,
and 100 yards. The other people know the rules, and that's why they got the information, and that's why we've been lacking, man.
That's why black people are lacking, and that's why I wanted to talk about it. And disclaimer, it wasn't that cut and dry. I'm just summarizing for the sake of time.
No, this is your story.
The major points that I do want to make clear is that you can buy a house at the age of 21. All you need is employment and schooling.
Okay.
So you can buy it fresh out of high school because school is employment history.
Damn.
And that's what the general population does not know. Mm. School is employment history. Okay. Mm. That's like my major thing.
I always felt like it was
work
going to school. I knew I was.
It is
work. He was clocked in.
Where did y'all go to school at?
Dover High.
The High.
Really?
You know.
Yo, you was at the old Dover High?
Yeah, I was.
Oh, yeah.
So not only was it work history, it was survival tactics.
You put your time in, man.
But it is very possible to buy your home at 21.
Yeah.
I bought this place at 21.
For real?
Yes, he did. Banks is...
Oh, my gosh.
Yeah, Banks is that one friend in our circle that's just totally responsible with everything in life.
Really?
Yeah.
Except for dates.
So what was your process like? Like, was it discouraging too? I mean, these jokers was just so harsh to me. Is it because I'm a woman?
No. It's because you're a Negro.
Yeah.
So
yeah.
It was me too.
You had two against you. Black woman,
yeah.
You know.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It was black, that's three. It was always a reason. I'll say it like that. Like, I would go to the bank, and what they made me do was I had to pay off my student loans first. I had to pay them all off.
Oh my God.
Before they would finance it, but I had enough money, so that's
the
other thing.
That's one thing.
He was the most responsible. Banks would probably been saving.
It was a lot of money
since he was 16.
Do this, do that before we'll grant you what you want.
Oh yeah. But, see, they didn't give me so much of the this or that, but I was really looking to be educated by somebody.
Yeah. In-call. Mm-hmm. I went to in-call.
I know what that is.
I went to in-call. It's a day class. You gotta sit there all day. But it's only gonna go once. You gotta sit there all day. And what they do is they guarantee you, they'll lock you in at a certain interest rate. So they'll do that for you.
They'll lock your interest rate that day that you sit there.
You sit there and they'll be like, all right, so we can lock you in at this interest rate. So no matter what, they can't go any higher than that.
That's what's up.
So that helped out a lot.
Tell the people what the interest rate is and what it means.
Back then, I do not remember what it is. Right now, it is 1.9.
No, not your rate. What it means.
Okay. 1.9.
That is sweet. First of all, that is sweet.
Well, I think he bought this house 10 years ago.
I just refinanced last month.
Oh, did you?
I did.
Congratulations.
Thank you
on your great rate.
Who helped you with that?
Myself.
No, you did your own refi.
Yeah, I did that.
No, you should have went to somebody.
Why?
How you do your own refi?
Hold on, man.
I came on here to educate. Now I'm getting educated.
Yeah, how'd you do your own refinancing?
So,
it's your interview now. I'm interviewing you.
So
I don't like dropping jewels.
Yeah, I don't like to help the community.
Oh shoot! All right, so hit up the lender. All right, so made sure my credit score was where it needs to be. I didn't have any outstanding debt.
Was your credit score over 650?
Yes. Mm-hmm. Yes, it was. So I made sure all that was in line. I also researched around who's offering the best rates. I went to somebody, I hit them up. They ran my score. They said okay, and that was it. I didn't get the runaround, not this time around. But the initial one, yes, I did.
Mm. So how many times did you refinance?
I've done it twice.
Okay.
I did it back in 2019 to get the check because I had a lot of equity. I was like, all right, give me that.
Okay.
Give it here. So I did that, and then I refinanced this year to lower my interest rate.
Nice.
So that's why I did that.
That's amazing.
But I do not suggest you do the refinance to get the check unless you are prepared for that because that money goes right back into your loan. So unless you're prepared to do that, I don't
basically
suggest
take
you do
from
it.
Yourself.
That's what it is. It's your money. You know what I mean? So
you gonna owe okay, later, even more.
Let's go to equity real quick. not to steal your tail.
Yes, my
let's
talk. Go, yes, well, I love it. I love it. I love equity. Money talk.
All right. Let's say you buy a home. All right. Let's say your home is worth $200,000.
$200,000.
You buy your home for $100,000. You have $100,000 in equity you potentially take out. All right. So let's say when you buy your home for $100,000, your monthly payment is $640 a month.
Make it $600 for the simple.
Please, $600.
If you were to refinance your house and take out another $100,000, your monthly payment is going to go up, and you will no longer only owe $100,000. You will owe the $100,000 plus whatever you took back.
Okay. Yeah.
All right.
Mm-hmm. So you're basically starting back at square one.
Potentially,
hey,
yes.
Plus whatever you took.
Yes, but you are cashing out with the cash.
Yeah.
All right. So if you're a go getter, that's okay. With, you know, you'll make that money back. You'll flip it. But that's you're taking from yourself pretty much.
Yeah.
I mean, unless you plan on selling. You know what I'm saying? Unless you plan on selling, that's a whole nother thing. You plan on selling, that's another thing. You get what I'm saying?
Well, this is a lifetime home.
So let me.
I will not be here forever.
Let me ask
own
you
it
this.
Though.
Not anymore. You know, I was down to 80 before I refinanced. I probably could have just paid that off and kept it then. But now that I refinanced, I don't think I'll keep it. Mm. Pretty sure I'll sell it and just move on.
I'm sure the equity's still there.
So. I mean, I got equity, but just better sell it and move on. But back to your tip. what was the house shopping? Looking for a home, first of all. Looking for a home you want to live in. What entails looking for a home that you will actually live in? Not just this house
yeah,
looks
what
good
was it for you.
Yeah, like not just like, the inside. You got to look at neighborhoods.
Yeah. You walk into the house and it was like, nah, that's not.
But
it.
You got to look at neighborhoods, resale value.
Yeah,
like, all right,
area,
you know what I mean?
Yeah, your future.
You know what? I didn't know anything. I knew nothing. All I knew was Milford and Middletown.
Okay,
that's all I knew, right? So I knew that Milford is up and coming because they're building all kinds of stuff down there. They got
shout
the
out
movie
to the
theater
We Are
now.
Milford movement. Who else is there? Who's down there? Mr. Powell, Zachary.
Yeah, Milford got a lot going on.
The Wing.
The Kickback, man. Let me get a discount for that, too. We need a sponsor from the
shout
Kickback.
Shout out to
Al
Mary's Kitchen. And I just heard about.
We need sponsors.
We need Matt. Yo.
Look, I'm shouting them out right now. Al Mary's Kitchen down in Milford. I just heard about A Blazing Grace down in Milford. I heard your ribs are delicious.
I'm gonna have to check them out.
Zing Gray. Look.
Oh, wait, I don't eat pork anymore. I wonder if they got beef ribs.
Shout out to Milford.
Put you to sleep ribs.
Nah, Jal, Sunday dinner.
Get some, man. Try them out, man. Can't shout them out till you try them out.
Oh, and my sister's.
My sister's fault.
I just
yes.
walked in there 3 days ago for the first time ever because my man at work been talking about these empanadas and my other guy.
They are all that.
Like,
they are
yo,
all that.
Go get them for me because I had a little run to go down there. Walked in, smelled delicious. Everything smelled delicious.
They're literally just all that.
Delicious.
What you doing on Friday, man? Let's take a little
I'm
trip.
Just saying,
man.
I'm
just saying.
I'm just look, and it's only, you feel me, 15 minutes from here. So.
Yeah, let's take a trip.
Man, do that thing. But yeah, when I was looking, I knew that Milford and Middletown. So Milford was up and coming. I don't know how true this is, but apparently Milford is going to or may currently be considered beachfront property. or it's in proximity of beachfront property, it so therefore the value is increasing or due to increase.
Is it Bowers Beach? That's like Slaughter Beach. Bowers Beach is like right
Bowers
to the left.
Beach is Frederica.
So and right is it Slaughter? Is it Slaughter then? What's that beach you guys? Wilford has a beach like right there.
Yeah, it's
so
right there. So it's like,
don't get me lying. There is a Bowers Beach in proximity. I know that. But I do know that. So I was like, okay, either Milford. So I was looking in Milford and they had all these new construction communities. Mm-hmm. But I'm just an impatient human being. I'm like, I'm not waiting on new construction. No. I'm not waiting.
You didn't want to build your dream home?
Dream home.
Building it? That's a whole different conversation.
I was going to say, in new construction, that process is a whole nother headache and I didn't want any parts. Okay. So I was like, scratch Milford, Middletown it is. And
booming.
Yeah.
Shout out to the kickback in Middletown.
Mm-hmm.
Go ahead, hook us up with 15% off.
We're not gonna.
Yes, we are.
We're not gonna. I don't know too many Middletown.
We're not gonna.
Shout
we're
out
not
to
gonna.
Amazon.
Nah.
It was out there.
Right. Nah, the kickback. Nah, let's not act like we don't. I go to the kickback.
I
to
do
get
not.
Shoes.
So.
Well, you need to.
Well, look.
Boom.
Bam.
I don't really know anything about. Well, I'm not a sneaker wearer, unfortunately.
Mm-hmm. Look, your man's in, so he knows.
And they had it in Dover. Yeah. Stop, because they was representing Dover too.
They were.
Oh my god.
My brother deals with the kickback.
It was a
my
pop-up brother. Shop or something. I think.
Well,
it
I think the Dover Mall rent got a little high.
Yeah, I'm sure it is mad high. And then you're right next to like Felton shit.
I mean,
you know?
They did it, but you from
they had it.
Dover Mall got the nerve, but. Corny one floor mall. Boscov's got two floors.
I remember when it was new.
They got an elevator in there too. They were
fairly new.
You remember when the mall was new?
I was born after, but I remember when it's fairly new and Blue Head Mall was on the way out.
Yeah, I do too.
I remember
too.
When
I do too.
I'd be trying to envision Blue Head Mall as a mall, and I'm listen, they got dialysis in there.
Just picture
a dialysis center.
Just picture this, man. A long behind mall, two floors.
Yep.
One, I don't remember the store on this side. All the Transformers a boy could play with. It was
the KB
popping.
Was in there,
and
wasn't
then
it?
No. Nah, and then out of nowhere, here comes Dover Mall. Toy stores, McDonald's inside, food courts.
Yep. McDonald's in the mall was so lit.
This is back when they had them daggone weird behind toys. Dover Mall used to be one long strip. They added the food court and everything, but somewhere down the line, it just died.
Okay, was Dover Mall just a random parking lot before it was the mall, or
it was made before
was
I
was it
born.
A warehouse?
Can't tell you. I know Home Depot
was new. I remember.
Home Depot was a swap meet, pretty much.
Mm-hmm. I remember
you
there
see
was
alligators
a,
and stuff in there.
Was it a
like,
BJ's? There was some grocery store where White Oak is. There
yes.
was some grocery store.
Hey, Metro.
Yeah. Metro.
Shout out to the Metro.
Metro.
Goodness, I miss you.
The Value City was near Save-A-Lot.
Jake's Burgers. It used to be Jake's. Yep. I don't know what it is now. Something Shaq.
But Metro, boy,
Target was just player, was just pure land. Yep. Target and Safeway was nothing but land.
Yep, all that.
Really?
Yep. We would ride our bikes behind there 2 times a day, probably.
Yeah, and I remember they opened that up right when the first X-Men movie came out. That's when they opened up Target. Yep. Like the same Friday night.
Man, you know what's crazy? I was just talking to one of my friends. You know, people are like literally scrounging to get out of Delaware. And I'm like, how come we're not making any efforts to make Delaware a better place?
Because the coons.
Like, Delaware could be all right.
It could be.
I'm going to say Dover could be all right because Wilmington is fun.
It's really...
If you like murder.
There you go, Killington.
Stop it, because I lived in Wilmington. I had a good time. It's all types of stuff in Wilmington.
It is, man.
All types of crime.
No.
You can't.
Stop for
they have lots
shout
of outreach.
Shout out to Wilmington.
They have lots of outreach. They got the PAL. They got the Boys and Girls Club. They got.
Look,
number eight.
My man's worked up there. He came outside from his job. His Escalade was on bricks. They took my man's tires and rims.
Shouldn't have looked.
In broad daylight.
Shouldn't have looked so good out there.
In broad daylight.
Shout out to Bobby Dimes.
Yeah. And I don't
shout
even think. Yo, you didn't even put that good old story
shout
in there.
Out to
Bobby Dimes. Wilmington,
yo,
stop
come
it.
Come on, man.
They stop
have,
it.
Wilmington has a lot. First of all, a lot of, you know, great talent, great
peace.
Entrepreneurs there. Mm-hmm. They just opened up
shout
in downtown. I think
Diddy.
It's called DECA. It's this, like, it's like an eating place, and it's like an outdoor eating. They got all this food inside.
A DECA, what is it called?
It's called DECA.
It was like a special ed course back in the day in school. DECA. It was.
What? First of all,
that's why it's
not being funny. It was.
That's why you know it.
It was. I'm not joking. It was.
DECA was not the.
DECA was. Okay, you know what DECA USA is?
DECA sounds mad familiar. I think I took the class.
DECA was the financial.
It was Skills Trade. They had a national organization for it. They got FFA.
I like Bay's answer better.
He knew what it was because he was a DECA kid.
General, I wasn't no DECA
kid. Your mama ran the DECA.
She did not. No, she did not.
Your mama was a DECA.
Oh my God! You want to talk about mama?
Your mom was a DECA.
My mother was a Delta. Get it right. We get it right.
Let me stop.
Your mama was a
DECA,
your sister was a DECA.
They were Deltas.
I like your answer better, Banks. It was a little special class that Eric was in. Oh, you know what? Hold on. Before you answer that question, got a question for you, ma'am. If it was your first date.
Yes, sir. There we go. If it was your
first date, and don't say it because he's sitting right here. We don't care, he's right here.
It ain't even got to be him. It could be anybody. It could be anybody. Don't put him on
the spot. If it was your first date.
You don't even know him yet.
Okay.
Bam.
And he said, hey, I like you. I want to go on a date with you. He said, okay. And you went on a date, and he took you on a walk on the beach.
Hold on. Don't give her a scenario. Don't give her a scenario.
You're leading the witness. Relax.
You're leading.
I'm trying.
If he spent $0 on you during the date, would you be okay?
No, that's not the question.
What's the question?
The question is, how much money do you spend on your first date?
That's leading because it's saying that you gotta spend money.
I'm asking her, is it a yes or no if you're gonna enjoy your date?
We're actually not. They're just doing a family dispute right now.
Because they took my question and tried to take it into their own.
You were doing it wrong. You were doing it wrong.
It was my question.
It was mine originally. Listen, how much money does a guy have to... How much money does a guy have to spend on you on the first date in order for you to consider it a date?
Yeah, that's what the question is.
And if you say no.
Or if you say zero.
If you say
then
zero.
Then they don't believe you.
I'm not going to believe you. He may, because I highly
and that's why I say that you guys try to trap him on saying how much money.
If she gives me an actual reason, I'll believe it. But you called up a lifeline and I do not believe her. It doesn't matter It doesn't matter. I just want to be with you. It's your first date.
I just want to be with you.
That's the first date. She doesn't know you like that.
But when you said first date and you said how much money does he have to spend, now you're making it seem as
if
though.
If she says zero, then
they already have a number.
So, how much does he have to spend? You know what? Can I be transparent with y'all? I never really went on a bunch of dates. Like, I haven't really been on any dates. So I'm going to start there.
Honey.
But
that's okay.
If I were to be on the dating scene, I am an individual who really admires creativity.
Hold on.
Because if you look on spiritual world, these females do not value it.
I'm sure your level is above 10. But believe me, even the ones appreciate creativity.
Yeah. So like he started off saying, a nice walk on the beach. But listen, but this is what I will say.
That's because I know women. These dark-skinned niggas is different, man. Savages. Go ahead, I'm sorry.
I'm going to say this. It is typical that individuals go out in the evening time. Let's all agree. Most of the time it's in the evening.
I will meet you at
in the evening,
seven.
I'm hungry.
Okay.
So I would like you to pay for my food.
Okay, bam.
I am prepared to pay for my food, but I would like for you to do it as the gentleman. Okay.
As the inviter. You invited me out.
Okay, yeah.
Yes.
Yeah.
Now.
And the price.
As far as the price.
We'll be dishing.
I really don't believe that females should be treated to some six-figure dinner or six-figure scenery off-rip. Okay. Like, what makes you think that you are deserving of that caliber when you haven't even proven that you can stimulate or calibrate or anything? Like, you haven't proved nothing. So, honestly, something simple. Like, I'll do a 2 for $20. We can go get a Cold Stone.
Okay.
fine, okay, as long as the conversation.
Coast on fire too.
I love Coast on. Okay, and now Coast on costs a couple dollars
they
though.
Do. That's just how I don't shit. Want. Yeah, I like, had marshmallows.
What?
I had.
I get the love it side.
Yo, you're yo.
You know they got the like it, the love it.
My original
marshmallows.
Nah, or is it the gotta have it?
A little bowl, maybe.
Butterfingers in that John. I need some chocolate.
I want the I want a couple scoops too. You know, you know, when you go over somebody's house, they be like, "Are you hungry?" I be like, "Yes."
Okay.
Yes. So yeah.
So you're down for a 2 for $20.
So you're down for a 2 for $20, but you're also down for a walk on the beach.
I'm outside?
In a picnic. Now you still gotta spend money. You gotta spend money.
We can go to Acme. We can get some lunch meat.
You're hating because
we can get some lunch meat. We can make sandwiches together.
You're hating. I'm not hating at all. And right now,
it's only because Banks isn't that creative when it comes to
you
women.
You gotta talk to your mom, your sister. You gotta use your resources.
I only said you were hating, and I want you to make sure.
You gotta use your resources. You know, women.
Banks, I want you to run it. I only said you were hating because you wish I was in your ear. That's all I was gonna say. He said you wasn't creative. He's a yo.
I mean,
he does
hard
this.
For him to come up with
these
a good
women
idea
aren't accustomed to creativity. They're accustomed to I'm gonna just take you out to eat, and then they sit at the table like. And not that I know this, but I just hear my girlfriends talk about it all the time. Like, yeah, girl. And I just pulled out my phone because he wasn't talking. And you know, most women. And I'm going to hold on. Did she pull out her phone? Girls be like.
That didn't happen.
Did she take a snap of herself?
It was not a bomb.
Girls be straight like this.
You're replaying his date.
You're reaching.
Did she no face, no chase you, Banks? Just to make her man's mad, Banks.
What?
You no face, reaching. No chase. Did you have a watch on? Did she put your watch in there? Which you know what I mean? But she didn't have your face.
There was no picture taken. There was no picture taken.
You don't know.
There was no picture taken.
Close friends and only in her close.
Okay, so I want to know: are men scared to get creative, or you just literally can't generate those thoughts?
All women want is a nice roll blunt.
I'll tell you right now, I'm crazy.
A nice roll blunt and $40. That's it.
We were just talking about $40.
That's it.
$40. That's the magic number.
$40 is ready in my cash app, but that's not the point.
At what point are you willing to cash app a woman $40?
I'm not cash apping anybody $40.
Me personally, in the past, anytime.
Nah, I've
not a woman.
I'm not just
so if a shorty that you know what I mean, it was
if I was getting that and she asked me for $40.
You gotta
think. So men have to pay their way, y'all.
No.
Y'all gotta pay y'all way.
Prostitution.
That's not well. Eric does it a little differently than everybody else. But if a girl who I was talking to, yeah, he is.
That's how you bumping.
If a girl I was talking to,
in his defense,
no, it's no defense.
You go to Applebee's 2 for $20. That's $20 for the meal. $3 for a drink. That's $6.
We're gonna drink three Long Islands apiece.
Exactly. You're already over $40. You're already over $40.
Hey, look
at me.
They're talking you guys into prostitution. Do not just be giving these girls $40 for the pussy. Don't do that.
I've already come with
so
the
great conversation. So he's just spent 70 on a date, a whole blown date.
Or he could take her on a walk
I've already had the great conversation.
I've already got her mind wrapped. On the beach.
I'm going to hold women and men accountable. I will say that the women only act like this because the men allow them to. Y'all be
that's
boosting
not really
up these
the men
females.
No.
These females thought out. They put their, you know, he got to do this, he got to be this, he got to be that. And y'all feed into it and pipe their heads up. But this is what I will say. I was talking to one of my male friends and I'm like, you know, man, all they want to see is these fake body females and the makeup and all this and that. And he was like, go ask any man to look at their TO. You're not going to see them posting that on their story.
True.
Only women repost fake body women. Men don't post that on their
stories. I think that's Banks' pet peeve with the girls he posts on our group chat. Like, they're all natural. I mean, he's like,
that's good.
He'd be searching for them.
Are you on your J. Cole?
Do men like natural women?
Oh, yeah.
Is Sweetie natural? That's my baby.
No, but I don't post that, man.
Was that a no to Sweetie or was that a no to you, bro?
Come on, dog. Whatever, John. I'm not saying you go off every 5 minutes, you feel me, just posting Jones. But the Jones that he posts,
you just tell him that I'm posting Jones in the
every
let me put this out there. Shout out to my ladies. You do whatever you want to do with your body. If you want to go get that booty done, them titties
to
done,
an extent.
Them lashes
to an
on
extent.
Do what you
want
to do.
If you want to get the BBL, man.
No.
Cause somebody gonna love it. Somebody gonna rub on that silicone.
Do it the right way.
Somebody gonna rub on
that silicone. You're doing it for the gram. They're gonna like you, Jones.
Don't go to Brazil. Don't go to Watco.
Go to DR. Just go to DR.
to a real live doctor.
What's his name?
Dr. Miami. Go Dr. somewhere. Miami. You're going to spend Miami. The bread, but at least you'll be Look, alive baby, to enjoy healthy. It.
You're
going to
get 200 likes, man. Go ahead.
Get
do
healthy.
It.
Get
do
right. It. Your body can transform.
Take care of your temple, ladies.
Your God made you one way, baby, and that's beautiful.
Take care of your temple. Strengthen your minds, because one day the physical is going to fail somebody. And all you have left is your mental and what's inside.
Do it, because you could trap a nigga early and you got him forever.
You got 20,000 followers.
Why do y'all trap people?
Why do
some women
there you go
trap men?
Well,
especially when you shouldn't be trapping said man.
They call it a twin flame. You know, women who be into astrology and stuff, they be like, "What's your sign? You're my twin flame."
I hate that.
My twin flame, and then like they think that the baby's gonna solve the problem. I don't freaking know. I don't get into that.
Babies are a gift from God.
I mean, do women trap the men, or do men make a contribution to walking in the trap?
Both. They definitely contribute. Yeah,
you know what
they
mean.
Contribute.
You can't trap a man by yourself.
Can you blame a rat? If you dangle some cheese in his face and he eats it, like, can you blame him?
On. Who set the trap?
Yes,
you can blame. Oh, and this is a female. You can blame Eve for taking it. That's a female.
Shout out to Eve for ruining the human race.
I know Eve. You damned
I tried,
us.
Eve.
Thanks a lot.
I tried to get
Kendrick
you.
Say, "God damn you."
Yeah. And then Adam was just dumb. This is where we fall into. Adam just took it.
Let me break it down.
Go ahead.
You're in a garden. You don't know no better. This naked wife of yours.
You can't even see.
Walks up to you with an apple. "Hey, eat this. It tastes good." What are you going to do?
Yo.
There's no prior stories. There's no prior history. You have nothing to go off of. There's no. Back in my day, my grandpa. There's nothing to go off of.
Hold
All
on.
You see is
pause.
This.
I'm gonna stop you right there, because God sat there and said, "You can eat from anywhere up in here, but not this tree."
Not that tree.
He
Adam.
Said, "Not
I
that
ain't
one."
Trying
Adam.
To sound perfect, but even I would take an apple from a woman if she's skirtless.
Ooh.
Who said that?
Me.
Ooh.
Okay. And okay.
Yo, can I get? God damn.
Shoot. Well.
You need to hurry up and write that down. Put that out for somebody to get you for
documented.
That bar.
It's already documented.
You might as well start ghostwriting, man. Yeah. Pack the podcast up. You got your next career.
Didn't they say they couldn't see beforehand? And
I don't know anything about that. All I know is they didn't have navels.
Yeah, I don't know.
I thought they couldn't see.
Look, I got a question.
Oh, wait, I messed it up some
you
more.
Did.
Oh,
you
shoot.
Did.
I'm in trouble.
That's
now.
Okay, Eve. We got you.
I was
you.
Trying to help. Oh, shoot. Are we back?
Hold on. I got a question.
Go ahead,
are you okay with him being the stay-at-home dad and you making the money?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, like, I'm cool with that. That's so dope.
Okay.
You, how many stay-at-home dads
Yo,
is
write
there?
That down. We got you, baby.
That works for me. I don't like cooking.
Okay.
My I can come home to a hot meal. Okay. I don't want to deal with the little one all day.
Shout out to my guy, Matt. He's a low-key chef.
Like, man, stay-at-home dads are great. And, you know, he could do other activities, too, like coach a team or something.
Now, we're not saying he's a stay-at-home dad right now. He does.
I'm just saying if he was, like, that's dope. That's different.
Because a lot of women wouldn't.
But, all right, so where's the line drawn between, all right, what does a stay-at-home dad have to do to be considered a stay-at-home dad and not just a bum?
I
was gonna say, look, that house got to be clean. The food needs to be cooked every day. Laundry washed. Everything
draws
iron.
Okay.
I want my bras hung up. I
Ooh,
want everything
bras hung up.
On fleek. Young she boy better
this.
Be better.
She already thought about this.
For real though, like,
look, he's gonna be a stay home dad. What are you talking about?
God, okay.
We gotta
make sure you get your notes on your
Palm
Pilot, man.
Okay. But I think the coolest thing about a stay at home male, whether it be a stay at home dad, a stay at home bum, a stay at home living, whatever you wanna call it, a woman know where her man at.
Okay.
And I think that may be one of the reasons why we have, you know, women sticking with these chicken heads, because you know where he at.
Yeah, I suppose.
You know where he at.
Until you give them your
They can never find banks. Makes noise on a bridge.
We're psych, psycho.
Until you give him your Nissan Altima and he's out here doing crazy things in it. Until you give him that Altima.
Your friend send you a picture of him in your Altima. He in the Chick-fil-A pickup line with two bags. And one of them made for you.
Yeah. Shout out to you for being understanding.
We got to change that perspective. We got to move that stigma.
There you go. Change that.
If all the things that you're not, you're understanding.
That's how you gotta be. That's how the world goes round. You know what I mean? Like, nobody's perfect. Nobody is the perfect package.
Nobody's the perfect date. Like,
was that a shot at me?
That was a hash out of her.
So let me ask y'all this.
Nobody's the perfect
date. Let me ask y'all this. What is like the ideal woman package? Because women are like, he gotta be tall. He gotta have waves. He gotta have.
Don't irritate me.
What is irritating you?
Anything
like?
To Banks.
Anything.
You don't like to be questioned,
huh? Don't blink twice in a row.
I'm not even gonna lie. I was over y'all house, and this was only on like Fridays. I think Fridays and like Saturdays. I was over y'all crib every Friday and Saturday. Tenders, pizza rolls,
French fries,
Avatar,
chicken tenders.
Watch you niggas play Counter Strike.
I wonder how y'all parents did it. I would be annoyed if it was kids over my house. I'd be like, y'all
only
go.
Went to his house. Yeah, my mom was a heaven.
I was about to say, so y'all was bouncing from crib to crib.
Shout out to the OG.
And we're different ages.
Shout out Miss Linda.
My mom, my parents they were party people. Yeah. I mean, I grew up to be DJ Illegal. You feel me?
Shout out DJ Illegal.
You feel me?
They had different age kids. Like, y'all ages are totally different. Yeah.
Well, I mean, Nokia's a stretch, but him and JR are pretty close.
But then you have Jamie and Jordan, who aren't.
That's Nokia's kids, though.
Yeah, but they were there every. What do you mean? They were there. They had a room there.
Yeah.
When was the last time y'all went outside to play?
Like, every day.
When was the last memory you remember going outside to play?
Senior year. I'll say senior year. Last time we all actually.
Like, you really played. Like, what
basketball,
was the last thing?
When was y'all senior year? 100 years ago?
Relax.
What year did you graduate?
2005.
You know how old I was?
I'm 11.
What year I graduated?
Yeah.
I can't tell y'all that.
I just graduated last year.
I can't
from,
tell you guys
outside
that.
Played, man. It might have been like 2009. What's your definition of outside to play?
Outside to play, like really just like was running
like
around. You smelling like outside.
High school. It's got to be before high school.
Maybe no. After,
I'm talking sneakers dirty.
Yeah.
You running around.
I'm talking Banks drunk at the basketball
I'm
court.
I'm talking about kid and play
2006.
Play.
2006.
You're not gonna elaborate on that, Banks?
All of us though.
Yeah.
Everybody.
2006.
Andrew quit on us.
I'm talking about when y'all was children.
You're not gonna elaborate on you drunk at the Banks. Banks.
Nah, the last time.
Banks, I know you can hear me. You're not gonna elaborate on you drunk. Eric told me this story. I wasn't there. Old enough.
What a
Eric
snitch.
Eric told me.
Anyway.
It was an epic night.
Anyway, it might feel like 2004, last time you just got outside and played.
What year did you leave for the military?
Hold on, you want to say outside just playing with we play baseball. We played baseball like 2006.
Where did y'all play at? Like, where was there to play in Dover?
Lincoln Town Point, White Oak Connection. Shout out Bay Tree. Shout out Manchester. Shout out Spruance Road. The whole east side. That's where we lived. That's where we grew up. We had Williams Park. Big baseball field. Always open courts.
Okay.
We had some of the best ballers that come through the state ball.
And I smoked them all.
Much. My freshman year in college, I came up on a fake and I was moving.
Did you?
I'm not gonna be in no hot house party.
But you got a short.
It worked. I got short.
They look at you like,
hold on,
you
wait. I'm gonna tell y'all a quick story. No, it did get taken this one time, okay, and okay. I was ready to get it popping. We went to Richmond. And it was. Yeah, I was. This is my party bull. Like, we was out here. He came everywhere with me.
Sneak you in, bull. We got one.
He was. This is the big homie. We had such a good time together. We went to Richmond. You know, we all cute and everything. We turned up all the way there. Yeah, it's about to be turned up. We drove like an hour to this club, and we get up there, and he pulls out his ID. Mind you, I'm lit, and I'm just soft. Well, I was probably drinking Malibu. I'm gross.
Malibu.
So he pulls out his ID. He got a Delaware ID. We're in Virginia. Mm-hmm. So the dude, he's rubbing on it. He doing
bro,
most.
About to break your jaw.
And Isaiah's like, yo, if you break my ID, we're going to have a problem. And he's like, this is fake. And he's like, no,
shit.
It's not. This is fake. He's like, let me see your ID. I pulled out this ID. It is a Asian girl named Ariel Reyes.
You should have went like this.
And it was working all up into that time. He was like, this ain't you. I'm like, yes, it is. He said, this ain't you. And put it in his pocket. I'm feeling corny. Mm. I'm just feeling crazy. Like, I'm sitting there.
I know it's not me, but.
Yo, you should have hit him. Yo, honestly, you should have hit him. You should have looked at him. Looking dead in the face and said, "Uncha wa wa," and boom, got your drink.
I didn't even pay
she
for it.
She was Chinese. You would have hit him with that over.
I was so embarrassed, and it was Kamichua. Other people. You know, people like see you have to walk away and stuff. People looking out the joint. I'm feeling corny and shit. Like, oh my god, like I'm really a young bull. Like this is. I had like 2 more years.
That's because you didn't turn up enough.
Wait, let me ask y'all something. Mm-hmm. So as men in relationships, can your girl sleep? If you were a man in a relationship, can your girl sleep over her friend's house?
Yes.
Yeah.
You get that's okay.
This is why I look at it. Some of them don't agree. Let's say this.
That's not even a question. You can't sleep at your friend's house.
She will not. Her boyfriend will not let her sleep over.
He's cheating. Leave him. Yo, he's cheating. Leave him.
He's talking about we too grown for that.
I got it. Hell, I got her. I got her.
We too grown for that. I'm like, how are we too grown for that?
I bet you from time to time.
A lot of it is not built with the confidence to leave their girl anywhere.
That's dumb.
Yo, hey, I bet you.
If I can't trust you like that, I don't need to be with you.
I bet you from time to time.
You don't have the confidence to trust.
He accuses her of cheating, man. He's a bad vibe, man. Get rid of him. Unless it's your man. If it's your man, then no. Yeah, get rid of him. But it's your man, he cool.
He don't trust.
Keep him forever.
You have a group of friends, right? You're all in relationships. Can you go out of town for the weekend? Your girl needs a ride home. Would you be cool with Andrew taking her home at 12 o'clock in the night?
You wanna know the funniest part is? I just had a conversation with my shorty.
About this.
What did we go out last night? Mm-hmm. 2 days ago?
She's drunk. She's all over the place. You're not in town. She needs a ride home.
Is Andrew my man's or is that
he's
her?
He's your man.
Oh, yeah.
No. This is friends. This is Eric. No. This is living single. This is living single. This is friends. This is modern family. Yeah, whatever sitcom we're all friends.
Give me my man's. Give me Eric. Don't give me Andrew.
We're all friends. We're all friends.
Say if I put you in a group chat and Andrew's in the group chat, we play Call of Duty together.
Don't give me Andrew. We're talking.
We got to give you Andrew.
When you say Andrew can go pick up. Come on.
Because, well, it's difficult for him to answer because it's like, it's either your family or foe with him. Like, the friend in between is like, maybe.
You're
like,
not a friend.
I know.
Anymore.
That's what I'm saying.
You're
there's like no in betweens. Like,
yeah.
He's either going to totally trust you with his life or you're not even going to be in. Like,
that's why when
vicinity.
I said, you said Andrew or a friend, yeah, and I'm like, give me Eric.
You're making this complicated. I said we're all friends. We're all friends.
We're all friends.
Scenario. We're just scenario based. Not Andrew. Friends. I just said
okay,
a name.
So,
I trust my girlfriend right now 1,000%.
Right.
If anybody picked her up, if a nigga I didn't know picked her up, I said, yo, go pick her up right now. That's okay.
Exactly.
Can't say there's always like that for everybody.
There's literally people in the group chat who would not let their girl braid my hair because he didn't want me sitting between her legs.
Codename.
Codename, who you think it is? It's only, it's, I mean, it's probably it's only
so
one.
So y'all would let your girl know. Braid somebody hair?
He would not let his girl braid my
what
hair.
What we talking about?
Is that a little different?
No, I'm just asking.
Because, I mean, think about it, Banks. Mario just came out with, trying to mind your brain. My hair.
Who are we talking about?
My hair.
Get out of here.
Would you let him take your best friends home if they were drunk?
Yeah.
Okay, well, you're responsible.
I would rather him than me because, look, I'm impatient and I might mess around. We're not going to be where we're supposed to be. We're going to be in Wawa playing, running
too
around.
They already called you food. They talking about you got to pay
I don't
for
need
it.
If I got to question it, I don't need to be friends with you. And I don't need to be in a relationship
well,
with
see,
you.
Well, see, that's what I'm saying.
You're Banks, like, you can blank out the name. I don't know who you're talking about.
Let me that's just cool. say this. Shout out to Isaiah. He's like the pickup god. Like, he came and picked me up from so many situations. Me and my friends, a mess.
That's
this white girl
you.
Wasted.
That's because he likes you.
White girl
this
wasted.
Before y'all were dating?
Before,
oh, yeah, way in, yeah.
That's
because
he liked you. Come on now.
I'm pick like,
you
up, Isaiah, got I'll stop you. That. He'd be like,
he probably
yo.
Said, no problem loving
I'm
that joint.
No
problem loving that joint.
On
what
the
you?
Way. This man, this how much he loved me. Because I'm like a 70-minute partier. Like, I'm so soft. I'm telling you. Man, he sat outside the club for homecoming. He sat outside the club. He's like, yo, like, I know you finna be in there only for a few minutes, so I'ma just sit out
well,
here
he
whatever.
Well, he know you didn't. See, that's...
Man,
that's,
he sat outside the club. I came up, Isaiah. This is, Isaiah. Do y'all welcome new friends as adult males?
Fuck no!
No.
Or is it?
No, I haven't accepted a male request probably one out of like the last 5 to 7 years.
So there's no such thing as building new relationships as an adult.
No, there is.
It's about energy and stuff. Like sometimes, at least around here, I can immediately feel if you're off sometimes. Like this, I shouldn't even be able to talk to you right now.
The last time I met some friends,
I've been a scumbag.
And it's very rare because guys meeting other guys to be friends with, you don't even have to be totally alike, but you have to like a lot of shit. Like you have to, I don't even know how to explain it.
Yeah, well,
like, yeah, becoming a male friendships are just
you either have to be from like
the vibe. You know, most male friendships when they start, the vibe is usually on the same level. Like you like. I just recently friended a work friend.
More than likely, it's going to be somebody from work. Because you're not going to go out and meet a guy.
That's not happening. We're not going out, hey, man, I like your shoes. I like yours too. What's up?
Yeah, bro.
That's not happening.
Unless we're at Comic-Con.
So it's common ground. You hate this job. I fucking hate this job.
Yeah, man. Screw Debbie.
Yeah, my last guy friend was Keith and Mark.
You at Walmart throwing boxes. I'm at Walmart throwing boxes. We throwing boxes.
Yeah, we doing oil changes together, but we're going to go up and turn up and drink this Henny. Yeah.
Oh, wow.
That was like 4 or 5 years ago.
Just recently, energies was just good. I just knew that was like a version of me 20 years old. Like,
so what is off-putting energy? Is it like someone who can't make eye contact?
It's whatever your energy is.
It's when you go after a joint and the nigga says, oh, I like her too, I'm going after it. Don't talk to the nigga, man.
All right, man. Illegal, you got somebody you want to let be known?
Yeah, man. I'm going to give a big shout out to my guy, Terrence. Hooking me up. You see, I know you see me wearing a gear all day. We try to put some black business on black business. All right, hold on.
That shit was cozy. Stand up for him. Shit, yo, I felt it. Jones, mad cozy.
Nice logo.
Nice
logo. He got some great.
Nice embroidered.
Yeah, it's good fabric. I'm warming this thing.
And he got some great meaning behind it. And I'm not going to go ahead and state his mission statement or nothing, but y'all go ahead and check it out. Rage clothing.
All right, man. How about Rage? Drop the link for us. We can get some more stuff up here. You know what I mean? Let's do it. Let's get Rage to the top of the building. We raging, baby. All right, man. We're going to wrap this up. This was fun. Camera's about to die, I'm pretty sure.
Yep.
Shoot.
All right. DJ Illegal. I'm finding DJ Illegal.
Yeah, you know where I'm at.
You can find Kenya at Unidentified Black Man.
That's all we are.
The Fiend Slayer.
And you don't want me to start flaming shit up. I'm not really a jokester.
You are flaming.
You don't want me to do this.
And let them know where you can find.
Unidentified Black Man. You already know.
Man, don't know where you can find me at. I guess I just can't be found. Nope. No, you guys can find me on Instagram at Ena, EEENHA. And I will be your next mortgage loan officer coming to you soon.
Okay.
Are you giving out free game? Anybody can hit you up?
Yes.
Or are you charging $20 like the people who did
you? Should charge $20.
I would charge, but I charge like $100.
Listen, please hit me up for the free game. I am in the process of becoming a licensed mortgage loan originator, so I will be originating loans and helping my people become homeowners. We're going to put more people in their houses.
I
need one.
More residual
ASAP.
Income.
I'm ready.
It's on the way, so a lot of good stuff on the way. Look, when you make your course, I'm going to have to come in and I have to put those funds out so I can learn how to edit videos and make my own little
Hefner house. You feel me? If anybody can help with that, I'm going to have a girlfriend. You know what I'm saying?
You mean wife? You mean wife?
But all the joints are going to be, I'm not going to look at any of them. But they're just going to be for the house and for the money.
Just for the house. Yep. We were talking about stay at home. Folks, so you'll just have some of them. Some nice stay-at-home mannequins.
All right, we out.